So what we have here is a typical setup that you see in your factories. We have an electrical motor that's driving a pump, which is circulating some water. This motor is driven by a frequency converter that's hidden inside the panel. But we can see the display of the drive. And we have the possibility to simulate a few failures in the system that are typical for any application. We have a motor fault being a stator winding short circuit. We have some load simulation faults here. And we also have a means to create a mechanical fault. And what I show you now is how the drive reacts to a mechanical fault. So when I press this handle here, I can actually create a misalignment of the shaft, which is connecting these two. And this misalignment is a fault, but it's not actually a critical thing. You can still operate the system, no doubt about that. But what this will create is additional stress on the bearing. And this will accelerate the wear out of the bearing significantly. So if you would continue running with this, your bearing will break very soon. So let's look at what the drive is doing in this case. For this, I would start the drive. So now the system is running its application, it's pumping the water through the pipes. Everything is okay, the drive is happy. But now let's simulate the failure. So I'm creating this misalignment now. And with the vibration sensor that is connected to the drive, the condition-based monitoring functionality inside the drive will actually notify us there's a high vibration. So with this notification, now you can start planning the maintenance. You can continue running, but you can start finding the right people, the right tools, the right spare parts. You can actually plan when to do it. Maybe you find a weekend where you can execute on it, or maybe you have production stops anyway. So this just allows you to plan maintenance. As you've seen, the notification comes to the display of the drive. This is useful sometimes. Sometimes it's not because there's no people around it. The drive also provides the status information through the field buses, so you can read it from the bus. And you also have the possibility to put the information out to analog inputs in order to switch on some traffic light being next to the machine so the operator can actually get this information.